To begin using Movie Captioner, the first thing we're going to do is click the Load Movie button. Find the movie on our hard drive. Click Open, and we'll be asked to save our project. This is so the automatic save feature can work. Now, before I begin, I'm going to turn the movie down here. You won't be able to hear me speak. And I'm going to adjust this repeat interval to 3, because I happen to know that there's 3 seconds of music at the beginning of this movie. So instead of hitting the play button, I'm going to instead hit the start button. And all I do is type what I hear. And like I said, there's just music at the beginning. So I'm going to put in parentheses music. And I'm going to hit my return key. That will set the first caption. And you'll notice that the movie went on to the next 3 seconds of the movie, whatever set in the repeat interval. I can adjust this anywhere from 1 to 11. I'm going to set it to 4 now. And if you change that, you're going to have to hit the start button again. So I'm going to hit the start button again. And all I'm going to do is type what I hear. And I'm just going to go ahead and set all the rest of the captions. Okay, I've gone ahead and set all my captions, as you can see over here on the right. This is a short movie. It's only a minute 20 seconds long. I can click on any of these and see the captions, and you'll see that they're not very evenly spaced. There's only 3 words on the second line. I can do something about that though. If I go to edit up here, I can type a pipe symbol. It's the key right above your return key, and you have to hold the shift key down. If you type one of those as a marker for a carriage return, you'll see that it forces a carriage return. Well, we can't use our carriage return because we use that to set the captions for the best speed. So we're going to use this pipe symbol. So I can go through and I can just visually see what about halfway is for each of these and break up each caption. Now I could type the pipe symbol as I'm typing, but I prefer to have all the text in and set them afterwards. So I can go through and set all the line breaks for all these captions to make them a little more readable. And at any point, I can preview my captions in QuickTime just by going to the Preview in QuickTime button. It'll launch the QuickTime player and begin playing the movie. At an Army Air Force base in Arizona, women mechanics, and you'll see that that pipe symbol doesn't show up in your final export. A plane named in their honor gets a thorough going over by the Air Wax, as they're called. Now, at some points, I put a blank caption in so that the captions would expire. You'll see it coming up here. Okay, that's a blank caption. Otherwise, the last caption would still be up. So if I'm done previewing, I can just close that movie. If I need to do more editing, I can. If you happen to stop editing at any point, go to the last caption that you set, click on it, and then click the Cue Next button. And that'll reset everything to the next point where a caption would come in. That's what the Cue Next button is for. Also, when I'm previewing, if I decide I don't like the text, the font or size, I can go ahead and reset it in the text window properties. Let's say I want yellow text and a blue background. Once I set that, they're not set yet. I have to click this button, and that'll change all the captions to those settings, and it'll tell you once you do that. So let's preview it again real quick. And you can see we now have blue background and yellow text. And a little built bolder font. If you're doing larger DV movies, you might need to set the height of the background where the text is. I could set it anywhere from 20 to 100 pixels. We'll set it to 80 real quick, so you'll see what that does. You can see it's a much larger text window. So that's how you control that. That's really the basics of how to use it. At any point, I can delete one of these captions by selecting it and click the Remove Caption button. I can insert a caption by clicking a caption and then clicking the Insert Caption button. That'll insert a blank caption right before that caption. I can split one in two if I think the words are too long, if they're not fitting, if they're running three lines or something. I can select anywhere within a caption, and I'll say Split Caption. You'll see it made it into two different captions. Once you're all done setting captions and you're happy with the preview, you have a lot of different options for exporting. You can also import text and paragraph and line form, and then you'll get this button, Set Time Code. Once you import everything, you just click the Set Time Code every time the new caption is spoken in the movie, and it'll automatically time everything for you. Or you can insert a blank caption, same idea as what we see down here, to make a caption expire. So that's how to use MovieCaptioner. If you have any questions, there's a how to use MovieCaptioner, which you'll probably see on the demo that keeps popping up, and that will go away once you purchase the product. And you can also email me at support@synchromedia.com if you have any other questions. Thanks for trying MovieCaptioner, and good luck with your project.